Check in with meteorologist Jason Sudeikis. Jason, it felt like a summer day, good day for barbecue, and just a good day to be outside.
Isn't it great when you're wandering around outside and you just smell the grills in the air? I don't know. There's something to that. There's definitely something to that. But yeah, if you haven't eaten yet, I mean, I hope you have. It's getting pretty late. But if you haven't, be a good night to throw some food on the grill. 64 is where we sit. Got a little bit of cloud cover out there, but slight breeze out of the south at 6 miles an hour across the state. That cloud cover you can see working its way eastward really has dried up a bit to the northwest, but still some cloud cover south of I-80. So heading into the day tomorrow, we're looking pretty good. 80s for a lot of us. 80 Pleasant Hill for a high. Again, we'll have a few clouds out there, but those temperatures warming up. We're back above 70 by 1 p.m. We're hanging out in the mid to upper 70s for most of the day there. Areas like Urbandale, again, 80 degrees, starting off in the middle 40s. Again, maybe a little bit of cloud cover into the late morning, early afternoon, but that clears out and leaves us with sunshine and highs in the upper 70s to low 80s. So a pretty good looking day. And we're going to be pushing into top five territory here. Record for the day is 89, set back in 1929. But you look at that 81, that is not out of reach. That would mean a top four day that set back in 1942. So we're warming up hour by hour here. Eventually, though, you'll see a little bit of rain. You can see some of the clouds working their way through and perhaps just a little bit of a spit of rain as we head Sunday into Monday. With better chances into Monday morning, you can see some more showers, mainly metro southward, working their way through and perhaps a bit of a break for northern portions of the state. And then even some thunderstorms up by the Minnesota border Monday into Tuesday. So could see a bit of rain out of this. Some locations could pick up anywhere from a quarter of an inch to an inch. You can see areas like Ames at 0.4 of an inch, a little over an inch for Waterloo. Really going to depend on where some of those thunderstorms do fire up, as they'll be the rain producers out there. But for tonight, we've got the clear skies. Got a good chance to spot that space station as well. That's right after the newscast. So if you want to check that out at 9:31, that'll be visible for 3 minutes. You look off to the west northwest, 10 degrees is right on the horizon. But the max height on this is 29 degrees, so you should have a pretty good chance to see that as that travels to the south southwest. Looks like a little star just zipping across the sky. Pretty cool thing. 45 degrees tonight. Again, plan for pleasant conditions. And tomorrow we're back up to the upper 70s to low 80s. So pretty good looking day. I think we top out at 81 and we've got plenty of sunshine out there. Could be the warmest day of the year. Likely will be the warmest day of the year so far. So Easter looking pretty good. After that, we cool off. Chances for showers and thunderstorms. Again, they'll be spotty on Monday. Then we'll bring in more chances Tuesday and Wednesday. Could even see a stronger storm or two. After that, temperatures cooling off. Low 60s by Thursday. Now.